I think one thing that turns out to be very important if one wants to know something about world archaeology is travelling around the world. In that respect, I think I've been very fortunate. Quite early on, I was asked to become one of the lecturers on the Swans Hellenic cruises, which at that time were mainly in the Mediterranean, and Sir Mortimer Wheeler was the great guru figure who appointed the lecturers, just as he did many things in the British Academy, he asked me to take part. Initially, I wasn't able to because I was excavating in Orkney at the time. That must have been about 1974, but I did go on the SS Minerva, which was... the SS Ankara was the first boat, and that was terrific fun. The deal is that one simply had a cruise. One wasn't paid for it, but one had a very interesting cruise. And at that time, there were very eminent people among the lecturers. That's how I got to know Henry Chadwick and his wife Peggy, whom I got to know and admire very much, and quite a lot of other very interesting people, so that when one had given one's own lecture, one was very much inclined to go and hear the other lectures because they were really very informative. And the passengers at that time, I think it's changed a little now, the passengers at that time were really very interested in the subject matter. They were on that cruise because they wanted to go to those sites and hear about them from people that knew about them. And so that took one around to a lot of Mediterranean sites that one might not otherwise have been to. Visited quite a lot of sites in Cyprus, for instance, was regularly going to Constantinople. I knew many of the Greek locations before, but one very agreeable cruise, we went through the Suez Canal, so we were able to go to the Mount Sinai Monastery, St. Catherine's Monastery in Mount Sinai, which is an amazing place, a wonderful experience, and to Petra, which I hadn't otherwise been to. And on that cruise also, we went across by bus to the Nile and went to Luxor and Karnak, which I hadn't seen before. Jane, my wife, was invited to do some paleo-ethno-botanical work, some botanical work on the finds from Tel El Amarna one year by Barry Kemp. And she enjoyed that very much and found that interesting. And so he invited me to go with her the following year. I hadn't been to Amarna before, and suggested quite a small but interesting project involving some site survey, localized site survey, for me to do something useful, though I think you're probably more interested in the cereal remains than my site survey findings. But that was a great experience to be working in Egypt, gave one a little bit more feeling for ancient Egypt, and of course allowed us to spend time in Cairo. And then the Swans Cruises took us to Luxor and Karnak, as well as over the years to quite a lot of other places. And I should have mentioned there also the invitation we had in quite early days go to Iran. Frank Ho was excavating the site of Ali Kosh, which was one of the earliest village settlements in Iran. And he was finding a lot of obsidian, so he wanted a study made on his obsidian. And the obsidian analysis work was published by then. So we went out and I worked on the obsidian, saw all the obsidian fragments and selected quite a few for analysis, and they were subsequently analysed. And Jane was doing work again on the cereal remains. So that gave us the experience, my only visit so far to Tehran, and then down a wonderful train journey down to towards the Gulf to the town of Dizful, and then by road. It seemed very remote indeed. Dizful seemed a very sort of 19th or 18th century place as we arrived there and went out to the village of Ali Kosh, where we were staying in mud huts. Our daughter, Helena, our oldest child, was just a couple of months old then, but we decided it was safer to take her while she was still drinking her mother's milk than it would be from all kinds of baby foods, which I think is basically the case. So she was with us. But coming back from Deh Luran, it seemed as if we were coming to the very centre of civilization when we got to Dizful, whereas the bright lights of Tehran were completely overwhelming when we got back to Tehran. But that allowed us to see some of the great sites like Susa and so on. And then, as I think I mentioned earlier, when we were filming at Hatra in Iraq, that gave the opportunity of seeing some of the great Sumerian sites. And over the years, we've seen some of the Chinese sites and been to Mexico a few times. It's still my ambition to go to Peru. I haven't been to Peru, and I'd like to see something of the early civilizations of Peru. But these travel opportunities, they sometimes seem just like fun, and indeed they are fun, but I think they're seriously useful. And indeed the discipline on the Swans Cruises of having to really do the reading and know about the sites. Some of the sites I already knew about, if we were in Crete or the Cyclades, and or Troy or Mycenae, I could speak about that really knowing the background anyway. But when we did a Black Sea cruise, for instance, I'd been to Varna, which I was able to talk about, and Constantinople, but the other Black Sea locations I had to read about first, so it was quite demanding. Of course, when one knows how to find the right classical authors, it's not very difficult to read it up, and one has some background to give to it, perhaps. And of course, not all the lectures on such cruises are actually here we are in such and such a place, this is what happened here. They're more background lectures like radiocarbon dating. Or one very favourite place on the cruises was Santorini, where the great eruption was. And since the early days, I've been in touch with that excavation project. Spiridon Marinatus was excavating there in the 1960s when Jane and I visited him, and then Christos Dumas took over from him when he died, and we've been in touch with that site. Easy to talk about that, but also very nice to have the opportunity of visiting such places quite regularly, and all the sites on the Anatolian coast. So those, I think, are important opportunities. It's very difficult to see how one can really form a view of the importance of different sites or their significance in developmental processes unless you've seen some of them and can actually compare one with another.